While trying to save their kingdom, the heroes had been drawn into a tangle of intrigue and mystery. Following the...
You'll never get out! Not while I have you in my sight!
Then let's get out of his sight.
Where did they go?
We need to get out of this place, wherever we are.
Yes, and find out what's going on with Rosabelle and her sister.
This Isabel makes the trees and plants grow back home. Why would she do that?
Maybe she's a wicked cackling witch gone mad.
But it's Rosabelle who took her and locked her up somewhere.
My princesses ought to be nice and lovely, not tearing each other's hair or destroying kingdoms over crowns.
Thank you.
was the mysterious receptacle above the door? It seemed as if a shimmer of light was glimmering inside it. What was the mysterious receptacle above the door? It seemed as if a shimmer of light was glimmering inside it. What was the mysterious receptacle above the door? It seemed as if a shimmer of light was glimmering inside it. Thank you. What was the mysterious receptacle above the door? It seemed as if a shimmer of light was glimmering inside it.
This switch isn't doing anything.
It sounds like it's stuck.
Oh no, it's like the forge all over again.
magic forest has reached a human kingdom in the far west. They are rich with fat pigs and tasty sheep. No more snails. We go in the cover of forest, attack in the dark, and steal all their pigs. Oh, and their pies. And their pies. Their ales. And their women.
Ales?
Shh.
thick ice. My hammer's no good here.
Needed to melt the ice to continue their escape. the lava was powerful enough to melt the ice.
Dear Isabel, it's best for us both if you stay here for a while. I intend to be queen. I'm much better at it. Don't try to escape. You will be cared for during your stay, Rosabelle.
As the heroes read the letter, the kingdom's fate suddenly made sense. Rosabelle had taken Isabel's place as the crown princess. Something had gone wrong. And their kingdom had ended up in ruins and overtaken by goblins.
That sorceress! She'll meet the end of my sword if she dares show her face again.
The path stops here.
And it's a long way down.
How are you going to get away? Help me, little tree. Grow your branches long and strong so I may pass.
Isabel? She made the tree grow.
As if by magic.
The heroes had discovered that Isabel was indeed Rosabelle's sister. The journey back to Rosabelle's house took the trio down the side of a mountain and through the perilous haunted forests. Now their progress was made swifter, for it seemed as if the whole forest had come alive to help them get back safely. Hoping to catch Rosabelle off guard, they made their way to a balcony high atop the petrified tree.
Let's storm this lair!
It's kind of sad. They look so happy together.
Wait! There's something behind this picture. Look here.
Princess Isabel.
Your saviors are here.
Your Majesty, wake up.
Can you hear us?
Are you hurt, Princess?
We'll free you in a moment.
The heroes yelled and called for the princess, but she did not stir from her death-like slumber.
She can't hear us. She seems unconscious. Of course, the enchanted sleep spell. It's almost irreversible.
You shouldn't be here.
So, the artifact of souls is bound to you three. I wonder what happens to it when you all die.
The artifact will never help you.
You'll never get away with this, whatever your crooked plan is.
Silence, you rabble!
I didn't intend for the forest to steal Isabel's powers. But with your artifact, I can bring order back to this land. First, I need to get rid of you three. Let me introduce you to my little pet.
Oh, what's hurting it?
Aim for the earrings!
My warmest regards.
Stolen her powers.
Tremble in
these peasants. Death is not open to you.
Creatures of the night, heed my call. Deal with this rabble.
Wine arms holding the sleeping princess began to untangle and withdraw.
What is happening? Am I alive? Rosie!
The amazed heroes saw Rosabelle fall down into the underground lake. Isabel dived after the sinking shadow of Rosabelle. After a moment, Isabel returned carrying her sister.
Thank you for freeing me, heroes.
Pleased to meet you, Lady Princess.
If only the circumstances could be more cheerful.
Rosie, she was always very stubborn.
Can we get you anything? A towel?
I just want to go home.
I'm afraid your castle lies in ruins.
Not to mention you've some grave issues with your plumbing.
How are we going to get out of here? The portals are all gone now.
Just then, the trine appeared and shed its golden light around the cavern. The light grew warmer and brighter, wrapping everyone with an invisible blanket of comfort and safety. The cavernous tunnel vanished from their sight. The trine brought our heroes back to the very forest where the wizard and the knight had met at the beginning of the journey.
We did what we set out to do. Our kingdom is safe, and the forest has turned back to normal.
How did we do that?
It was Isabel's magic that affected the forest. Now that she's free, the balance has been restored.
No! I forgot to bring that magic water with me for the potatoes.
Here, I have a whole skin full of magic water.
Zoya! You're a decent sort after all.
It'll cost you 5 gold.
What? You already got a crown today.
The three heroes spent the night talking of the great adventure before they headed back home. So the princess and the pumpkins had been rescued, and the great adventure drew to a close.
The end? You wish? We've got a surprise. Ho, goblins are afoot.
On a dark and fateful night, sinister figures stirred in the woods surrounding Amadeus's cottage.
No sign of that thrice-darned husband anywhere.
Those no good heroes won't mess up our plans this time.
Let me tell you a little story that reveals more about the goblins we last encountered in the wilderness. As the goblins were doing their dark work, our three valiant heroes were returning home from their quest. Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya, heroes of the Trine, had come back at last after a long journey across distant lands. Lanterns and decorations had been put up all over the town in celebration for the heroes' homecoming. They stopped in the tavern to enjoy the warmth of the fire and hear the latest news. And Pontius, of course, looked forward to having a huge feast.
Barkeep, the champions return, and they are thirsty.
I'd better head home to Margaret. I don't want more trouble. I've had my share of dragons.
It's very quiet here. Where is everyone?
I have this feeling like we've forgotten something.
Let's see. We rescued the princess. We rescued the pumpkins.
Goblins! Goblins at the walls!
Hide your children!
Never a dull moment.
Yeah.
And I thought I'd have a nice cup of tea and a change of clothes. Where's it going?
Let's make haste. There must be more goblins at the walls.
Thank you.
hear something approaching.
All of a sudden, I really want bacon.
Yeah.
Maybe we should find Lady Margaret first. Before we go and kick them goblins out.
Never mind her right now. I'm sure she'll just breathe fire on anyone who even looks at her the wrong way.
I agree. Let's deal with these goblins first.
Stop right there and listen. We has the Margaret.
What?
Annabeth, is that you?
Margaret?
Oh, where in the devil have you been? Sort this out immediately.
The Wyvern will take care of you now. You're in for a little ride.
Oh, now I get it. You're staging a false kidnapping to get off the hook for disappearing.
And remember, don't come back, or the woman gets it. Have a nice trip to wherever. And somebody make her stay quiet.
Outsmarted by Wheeze the Goblin, the trio was flown away to distant lands by a terrifying wyvern beast.
Where are they taking her?
The wicked goblins had threatened to harm Margaret should the heroes return.
Cowards! All cowards! To steal an innocent woman!
A woman, anyway.
The new adventure had now taken a grave turn indeed.